Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to give you my thoughts on sea moss as it relates to healing fibroids and other reproductive issues. I know I'm a little late to the game giving you my thoughts and opinions on sea moss, so I'm spilling the tea now. I've been using sea moss for a little over 2 years now, and I do have some thoughts and opinions that might be helpful for you. In this video, I'm going to share with you what I like about this company called Herbal Vineyards Sea Moss. They sent me the golden sea moss and the purple sea moss to try. Their link is down in the description box if you would like to learn more about the company and the brand. I am also going to share with you a fibroid healing recipe and my favorite way to consume sea moss as often as I possibly can, which in my opinion is a great thing to add on a daily basis. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. My name is Chelsea Knutsen. I'm a certified holistic health coach and the creator of the 90-Day Walk to Fibroid Freedom Group Coaching Program, where I help women shrink fibroids naturally using food as medicine. There is a link down in the description box if you would like more information. So the reason that I wanted to talk about sea moss in general is because people ask me about it. Does it help shrink fibroids? Would you take it? Do you take it? How do you take it? What brand do you take? Like, those types of questions come at me on a regular basis. And so I wanted to come in this video and just answer some of those questions. There are lots of benefits to sea moss, which I'm going to touch on briefly here in this video, but there is one main reason I think someone with fibroids should include sea moss in their diet. I'm also going to share some reasons why I think you should consider this brand that I'll be talking about in this video. But before we talk about that, I just want to say a little bit about why people get fibroids, reproductive issues, why they have infertility issues, why people get sick in general. And there's two reasons. One is deficiency and the other is toxicity. And you might say, what are you talking about, Chelsea? Well, let's just say we get fibroids, we get sick, we get reproductive issues because of what we eat, what we drink, what we think, what we put on our bodies. That's the toxicity part. And we get nutrient deficient because when you're so toxic, even if you try to eat some healthy foods sometimes, and then you're eating the toxic foods and you're living a toxic lifestyle, you can't get the nutrients that your body needs to actually function optimally. So if you're deficient and you're toxic, that is a recipe for disease. That's a recipe for fibroids, PCOS, infertility, heavy bleeding. It's a recipe for emotional meltdown. It's, you know, it like instability in your body. It is a breeding ground for sickness, toxicity, and deficiency. So what happens when we're toxic, especially women, they start bleeding when their menstrual cycles leak. So they'll say, I get messages, people will say, oh my goodness, Chelsea, I got this heavy bleeding. I can't stop myself heavy bleeding. Can you tell me something to do? And they always want me to give them some pill to take or some herb to take that'll make it go away just like that, or tell them to eat something that'll make it go away just like that. And it doesn't work that way. The way we stop bleeding is we have to take some steps, but some consistent steps every day to clear the body of the reason it's bleeding every month. Like, you're bleeding a lot every month. And part of that is the deficiency and the toxicity. So we need to get rid of those two problems so we can stop bleeding. So if you wanna know what a period is supposed to look like, I'm gonna link a video up in the card so you can go take a look at it, and I'll put the video down in the description box about what you're supposed to bleed like. Women come to me all the time and they say, oh, I bleed normally. My cycle is normal. It comes every 28 days and it lasts for about 5 days. And I have a heavy day on the first day and the other days it's light. And when I really dig deep into what they're telling me, it turns out that they're bleeding way more than they need to. And if you watch that video, what does a normal period look like? You'll understand what a normal period is supposed to look like. And you'll get rid of the myth that maybe you aren't you're not bleeding that much when actuality you are. And if you're bleeding all the time, you have deficiency and toxicity. So I'm going to move on. Also, the other question that comes up is what to eat. What can I eat to stop the bleeding? What can I eat to shrink the fibroids? What can I eat to reverse this problem? And if you have that question in your head, there'll be a video up in the cards that can share that will share with you what you shouldn't eat and what you should eat to help you to correct this problem. Sea moss is not some miracle. Like you go and you take sea moss and all your problems go away. But what it will do is if you put the things in place that help you to get well, which is to stop living the toxic lifestyle with what you eat, what you drink, what you think, what you put on your bodies, and then you add sea moss to that, to your lifestyle, then that's when stuff will start to shift. Does that make sense? Okay, so how does sea moss correct this problem? Well, I'll go into some of the benefits of sea moss, and this will help you to understand what role sea moss will play. So you notice I said toxicity and deficiency, right? So we get rid of the toxicity by taking the stuff out of our lives that is causing the toxicity. But we also have to do something called flood our bodies with nutrients. And one thing that sea moss has that you really can't find in very many other plants, there's a few, but sea moss has 92 of the 110 minerals that our bodies need. It has beta carotene, vitamin B, vitamin C, and sulfur. It has minerals that our bodies lose through that bleeding and through us not absorbing the nutrients in our foods because our bodies are so toxic, and plus we're not eating foods that are nutrient rich. It also has magnesium, manganese, calcium, phosphorus, and zinc. So many people are deficient in these things. And that's why just adding your daily dose of sea moss to your smoothie or to your glass of water or whatever it is, however you drink it, is going to help you to reverse the toxicity and the deficiency especially. It nourishes your skin. It promotes healthy digestion. Like, so if you have digestive issues, it's going to help with that. It's going to strengthen your immune system. Lots of people are concerned about immunity. It's anti-aging because it helps with your skin, helps with keeping your organs young. It's an anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, antiviral. And some of you might be like, well, what's that got to do with fibroids? Well, the condition in your body that creates fibroids is lots of bacteria, yeast, mold, fungus, all kinds of pathogens that create the problem with the reproductive system. So if you're taking all the toxicity from the food and drink and things, what you're putting on your body out of the mix, and then you're adding something that is an anti-ager, anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, anti-viral, anti-this, anti-that, then you're kind of fighting back with the toxicity that's in your body, and you're pushing it out with something good. It also helps fight colds and flu-like symptoms. It improves emotional health. Like, one of the big problems with women with reproductive issues is emotional health issues, stress, anxiety. Also supports the thyroid function. And lots of people will go to the doctors and get their blood drawn and their thyroid number comes out normal. That number means nothing. I mean, it means something, but doesn't mean that your thyroid is functioning at optimal level. So adding some sea moss will help support your thyroid gland to nurture it and make it nice and healthy and, you know, give it good feelings, all that good stuff. I'm just trying to prove a point. It needs some support, and sea moss will help it do that. If you're trying to manage your appetite or your weight, sea moss helps that. It helps support a healthy heart. The list goes on and on. Those are just a few of the benefits that I can name for using sea moss. But I like Herbal Vineyards sea moss gel because I'm busy. I don't always have time to make the sea moss. Now, although they sell the traditional package of sea moss, you can prepare yourself most of the time. I would like to, but sometimes I'm just busy. And you could go straight to their website right now with the link down in the description box and buy a ready-made sea moss gel that is perfect. The consistency is perfect. Their recipe, how they create their gel, it's not too thick, it's not too thin, it's perfect. And it's already ready. They ship it right to you. All you have to do is take it and put it in your refrigerator. When you're ready to use it, crack open the seal and then just put your daily dose in into your smoothie or into your water and drink it. And that's all there is to it. Or you can buy the bag and prepare it however you prepare your sea moss. They have instructions on their website as to how to prepare their sea moss. But whatever you do, just get it in you. I like the gel because it's easy to use. And I also love the fact that they offer in the gel form both the golden and the purple. The purple is very high in antioxidants, which fights free radicals, which we need that because that's like killing all the stuff that causes disease. And they have the gold, which is high in phytonutrients, which helps with cellular communication. So what more could you ask for? It's already done for you. So that's why I like the gel. And like I said, you don't have to buy the gel already done. You can buy the actual sea moss. So let me stop talking because I'll keep talking about this because it's my favorite kind of subject, something to help you heal. So we're going to go into the kitchen and make this fibroid healing smoothie. And I will also show you my favorite way to consume sea moss.
Okay, so here are the ingredients for the smoothie. I've got 1 cup of frozen cherries. I've got 1 cup of frozen mango. 1 frozen banana. I have 2 handfuls of baby spinach. You can use whatever leafy greens you have on hand. 2 tablespoons of hemp seeds. You can use whatever fibroid friendly seed you have on hand. I love hemp seeds because they make the smoothie creamy. I have 1 teaspoon of vanilla flavoring. You can use vanilla bean powder, pure vanilla bean powder if you would like, or you could leave this out. Just don't use vanilla extract because it contains alcohol and that's not good for fibroid healing. I am using 1 tablespoon each of the golden and the purple sea moss gel for this recipe. You could use more or less. You don't want to overdo it on sea moss, but some people put up to 4 tablespoons in a serving. And if you are deficient, I can't see why that's a problem, but use your own judgment. Now for the water for this recipe, I have 2 cups here and I did add the 2 cups, but it was too much. So if I were to do this recipe over again, I would use 1 cup of water for a more creamy consistency. But if you like yours a little bit more runny, then add more water. So now all I'm doing is adding all the ingredients to the blender, my leafy greens, my frozen cherries, and you could use regular cherries if you would like to, but you'll have to make sure you take the seeds out. I'm adding the mango. And then I'm gonna add the banana, and you can use fresh bananas if you want to as well. You can even use fresh mango. And then we're gonna add our hemp seeds. And if you don't want hemp seeds, you can also use chia seeds. Just use them in small quantities, no more than 1 to 2 tablespoons for a serving. Now we're gonna add the vanilla flavoring. I love vanilla flavoring. Drop the bowl in the blender. That's okay, it's all clean. It's going down the same place too. But I also like to use the vanilla powder. Vanilla bean powder has a more pungent taste and it's fresher. And it's, I think, probably the better way to have vanilla. I'm adding water. You could use almond milk or hemp seed milk. I'll put a link down in the description and up above in the cards for my recipe for almond milk and hemp seed milk. And next is the star of the show for this video, and that is the sea moss gel. I'm going to go ahead and add that. So I used my high speed blender to blend this smoothie until it was smooth. This was not a very sweet smoothie. It was kind of savory. So if you like more sweet smoothies, you could add a little bit of raw honey to it or some medjool dates to make it a little bit sweeter. But it was a delicious smoothie and I could feel it working in my body as I was drinking it. So I don't typically put sea moss gel into my smoothies. I usually drink my sea moss in a glass of water with a little bit of lime or lemon. And the reason I like it that way is because, first of all, I like the taste better, I like the texture better, and I think the vitamin C in the lemon or the lime helps the minerals to dissolve or absorb into your system a lot better than if you didn't have it. So what I'm doing here is taking a spoon or two of sea moss and adding it to my glass. Then I'm going to take my citrus juicer and put my lime inside and squeeze the juice of the lime into the glass. And unfortunately, these limes that I had were not very juicy. So if you see, I'm squeezing that thing so hard trying to get that little bit of juice out. Unfortunately, that was the case, but it's not always the case. So I just squeeze my lime into the glass. And then I just add my water, which is probably about 12 ounces of water. And then I start vigorously with my fork for a couple seconds and then add my straw and drink up. So this is how I prefer my sea moss. And I just drink it down really fast and that way I can just get it in. Sometimes I even do it with less water than this. So it really depends on your preference, but if you enjoy putting them in your smoothies, go right ahead. The problem for me is I don't drink a smoothie every day, and I just want to be able to get the sea moss into my body. You can even take a spoon and just put, you know, take the spoon and take it into your mouth and drink and eat it that way. I don't do that, but I've seen people do it.
Okay, so what do you think of the recipe? Will you make it? Please comment below your thoughts. Also, if you would like to purchase this sea moss, there is a link down in the description box that will take you right to the Herbal Vineyards website to purchase whatever sea moss product you would like. So I have missed you all. Thank you so much for watching this video. And I want to just say that if no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. And I will talk to you all soon. Take care.